Jonesy
and Amanda. Jam
Nation. Our next guest, we love her. She's an absolute superstar. She's one of the most talented and successful singers in Australia and right around the world. 10 million albums sold, multiple ARIA awards, topped the charts in English and in French. What a show off. She starred in musicals, in films, in TV shows. We could go on all day, but let's talk about...
She starred with me in Dancing with the Stars. You missed that out.
I think she outstarred you. But she's about to kick off her Love Saves World Tour at A Night at the Barracks. It's going to be amazing. Tina Arena, hello.
Good morning.
How do you work a world tour into your life? Does your partner and your child go along, or do you just say, I'll see you later? How do you make it work?
Well, the child is a man child, so it's a different, well, it's a different stage now. He's about 6 foot tall.
Because Gabriel, he would be almost
18?
20?
18 or something?
18 on the 17th of November.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, so he's grown up.
Tell you what, though, you are going to love staying in a hotel, hogging the remote control, nice thread count on the sheets, room service. It does sound lovely.
Look, it is lovely. It's certainly not, you know, the 400 count Egyptian cotton bed sheets, Amanda, as people would like to assume. You know, the touring is pretty rough. It's a pretty rough existence. That's not to say that you don't have the opportunity of staying in lovely environments and meeting really great people. But being on the road is really, really hard work mentally and physically. So I have to psychologically get myself very prepared for it, which I'm starting to do now. And I'm just trying to not have any sort of anxiety come into the equation.
Well, you don't want that.
So, Jonesy, back off.
Well, I'm not going to do anything. I wouldn't make Tina anxious. I like to think that I'm a calming balm for you.
You are a calming balm, my dear man. Absolutely.
Does he need a kick in the balm?
No.
Well, Tina, before you head overseas, you are going to be starring at A Night at the Barracks. What can people expect from the Love Saves show?
They can expect to hear new music is what they can expect to hear. That's the principle of doing these shows. It's about new music. There's a new record. A lot of people really enjoy living in the past, and that's fine because that may suit them for whatever reason that they have. And I think that in music, what has been probably one of the greatest disappointments for artists, songwriters who need to move forward because it's part of our game, it'd be like you guys doing the same radio show every single day. I don't think you two would survive doing that. You know, I think made you guys magical is the unpredictability of, you know, and the beauty of every day, which is a fresh page. For us, it's really important to be able to get out there and just to do new music. The new record was written over the last, you know, three years, which has been a very difficult 3 years for everybody. Mine was difficult as well for a number of different reasons, not only what I felt was an extraordinary imposition, and, you know, and it's a stance that I've taken, which a lot of people don't really agree to, and that's fine. People are free to think and feel what they want to feel. So I don't hold back, but I think people know that is sort of what I am. I grew up in the media, so I can't stand in front of the mirror and the smoke. It's not a place I really want to be.
And you've got to reflect that. That's what the musician does. The musician reflects what they have. If everything was peachy pie, then you'd have nothing to write about.
That's correct, Brendan. And you know, things haven't been peachy pie, and I'm not at a point in my life where I'm going to sit there and talk about, you know, apple pie. It's been an interesting life, not only for me, but everybody's lives have changed.
Yeah. That's it.
Just live it.
Yeah, you just got to live it.
Yeah.
And back to us being doing the same thing. I don't know if you've heard our radio show lately, but
it's us and Roxette all the way.
It's us and Roxette. that's us.
Groundhog Day.
But it's not Groundhog Day.
No, I'm being facetious.
We reinvent the wheel every day.
We reinvent it every day. And Tina, my hat's off to you in the way you reinvent yourself as well.
It's good.
I'm just going to try and make it as bloody interesting as I possibly can. And then if anyone else wants to come along for the ride, you're so welcome.
We are on the ride. And Amanda is out there counting the thread count of her groupies whenever she stays at a hotel. She goes, this one hasn't got enough threads. Tina's Love Saves World Tour starts October 7th, starting at 9 at the Barracks, which returns its concert series from September 15. Tickets on sale from Ticketmaster and Ticketek. Tina Arena, it's always a treat to catch up with you.
Ditto, always a treat to speak to the both of you. Keep surprising us.